think I need to do this, even though I don't want to. Perfect. Oh, wow. That went across everything. Over face flake that stopped at this crack right there. That was pretty risky. Thinned down that middle real nice though. Took my time setting up that platform. Seems that it was worth it. Let's do that a few more times. It was a bit smaller than I wanted, but it's fine. Stop right along the crack there. It's a bit messy in there. I want to try and clean that up if I can. So I'll bring the angle back down this way, the platform. Bring the edge back down this way. Sorry about the neighbor. It's not happening there. Thank you. might be enough. Yep. Almost. The flake is actually going into that quartz there. You see that? I think the quartz is holding it on still. Okay, this side is a little bit wavy still, but that's fine for now. I need to work on this edge. I meant edge. I can straighten that up later with some good pressure flaking, a little more indirect coming that way. It's crazy along that crack there, all this quartz and things happening. It's really stepped out there. I don't know if I'll be able to take a nice flake back this way. We'll see. all over the place. Time for a break, I think. Sharpen up this pressure flaker a little. Not quite. Not quite time for a break. Oh boy. That was bad. That was bad too. What the hell? I'll end this video on that note. Nice basal thinning flake there. Slowly but surely, we're getting there. Uncovering more of this crack as we go along, but I don't know if I'm getting through the worst of it or just getting right into it. But it's held together so far. More of the same in the next video, pressure flaking and indirect percussion, until this thing is thin enough and regular enough for an agate basin. Getting closer.